story. I am still tipsy AF because badass chicas Joe Biden and Kamala Harris stomped the Electoral College runway to a narrow win with significant down ballot losses, honey.
Woo! Yes, Momo.
But guess who's bringing down the vibes with mascara smeared cheeks? Senate Majority Leader Mitch McCorpsel corpse hands.
President Trump is 100% within his rights to look into allegations of irregularities and weigh his legal options.
I know the Republicans are stubborn, but I think Joe Biden has what it takes by the end of his first term to forge a bipartisan agreement that he is the president.
I mean, that's the best case scenario. We need to keep fighting. It could take a generation before Republicans acknowledge Biden as president.
A good compromise would be getting McConnell to admit that Biden was the vice president from 2008 through 2012, and maybe all the way to 2016.
That's too aggressive once again, Brian. Just get McConnell to admit Biden is a guy. Don't let the president be the enemy of the guy.
Okay. Antonio, can you please settle this? What progressive policy should Democrats put on the chopping block in exchange for a peaceful transfer of power?
Look, we've never had a president or a loser in this case, in many respects, and in this one. Not acknowledge that he lost.
Got it. I was going to say climate change, but that works too. Moving on. Finger pointing has begun inside the Trump campaign, and it's pointed at Kimberly Guilfoyle giving Sheldon Adelson chest compressions with booty drops. Quote, senior campaign and GOP officials vented that Trump's finance team, led by former Fox TV host and Donald Trump Jr. girlfriend Kimberly Guilfoyle, underperformed and was an HR nightmare. She frequently joked about her sex life and at one fundraiser offered a lap dance to the donor who gave the most money. Now, I don't normally find myself supporting Kimberly Guilfoyle, but good on her for making Republicans recognize mature women as sexual beings, even if it meant forfeiting the presidency. Now, Antonio, I know you're dying to weigh in on this. When you were raising money for the DNC, how many times did you lap dance for Melinda Gates?
More than a few times, but I don't think we've ever seen anything like this. Unfortunately, these people don't believe in our democracy and have done everything to undermine it over the last 4 years.
But I have to say, it really makes you wonder what kind of misogynist, inappropriate environment is being fostered in the GOP. I mean, I just hope that when Trump runs again, they balance it out with men feeling the need to display their sexuality to donors. With Kamala soul-cycling her way through the vice presidential glass ceiling, the race is on to fill her old Senate seat, and it's giving me total bachelor vibes. Politico spilled the tea, saying many Newsom insiders insist that the governor wants to make a historic choice. Yes. We've got to center the underrepresented voices that make it past white gatekeepers.
Now, did you know that Gavin Newsom was married to Kimberly Guilfoyle?
Shut the fuck up.
It's where Kimberly learned to do her chest compression booty drops.
Right, yeah, we were all wondering about that. Now, Antonio, is the potential infighting for this seat going to distract California Democrats from the infighting the party needs to do nationally right now?
I don't think there'll be infighting. There'll certainly be some jockeying, and there's no question that there are many people that would like to be a U.S. senator representing the great state of California. But ultimately, it's going to be the governor's choice, Gavin's choice, and I expect that he'll make it soon.
You know, if the governor really wants to make history, have Dianne Feinstein fill both seats. She already talks to herself constantly.
Or go young and fresh. What is Mike Bloomberg up to these days?
Really both good options. We'll have to see who is meaner to elementary school students. Thank you, everyone. And now it's time for the Signal Boost. Broadway musicals can be beautiful, but as I learned recently, these enormous multi-million dollar productions full of intricate song and dance numbers can actually be pretty performative. This week, the New York Times reported that, contrary to the many bumpin', racially conscious rhymes rapped by its titular woke king, Alexander Hamilton actually bought, sold, and personally owned slaves. Of course, my first impulse was to get angry. How could Lin-Manuel Miranda, the most perfect, sexy ponytail hunk on the planet, lead us astray like this? But then I realized that there could very well be similar historical inaccuracies in my own work, specifically in my self-produced, self-written, self-starring 2017 musical, Hey Charlie, which tells the story of a scrappy young guitarist named Charles Manson and is against all odds success in the music industry. After a little digging, I discovered the unfortunate truth. Sometime in between his start as a musician and his eventual death in prison, he was actually responsible for several gruesome murders. Now, I know it will be hard for fans to hear such iconic numbers as Escape to Spahn Ranch, y'all, and La La La, I want a swastika on my forehead, and I cannot ignore this man's complicated legacy. Therefore, I've made the difficult decision to cancel the planned 2022 Broadway remount of Hey Charlie. And maybe old Lin-Manuel will take a page from my book too. Because as Charles Manson famously says in Hey Charlie's Act 2 opener, you just gotta do the right thing, baby! And that's your signal boost.